Welcome, everyone. Tonight is all about celebrating this wonderful year and recognizing the groups and individuals that helped make our successes possible. None of what we do would be possible without the support of our parents. Parents, we would like to thank you for carting your kids to and from rehearsals and concerts, giving them money when they ask way too late, and listening to the same music over and over again while your students practice. And most of all, for raising wonderful young adults and allowing us to work with them. Parents, thank you so much for all that you do. Now, Mr. Saikon will recognize our officers.
A big reason why the Byron Nelson High School Choir Program is so successful is because our students take ownership in the program. At this time, I would like to recognize our choir officers. We appreciate all of the work they have put into this year. They helped pick our t-shirt design, volunteered their time before and after school, and helped run class on a daily basis. Most importantly, they helped put together this presentation. We would like to recognize and thank them for their help and contributions to the year. Bella Voce section leaders, Samantha Leese, Jasmine Mondujano Pacheco, Kathleen Forte. A cappella section leaders, Marissa Lacefield, Avery Marak, Blaine Stone Cipher, Oliver Homan. Secretary, Ava Famularo. Historians, Sam Leese, Abby Horn. Logistics chair, Josh Doherty. Librarians, Jillian Brown, Jasmine Mondujano Pacheco. Wardrobe officers, Jasmine Mondujano Pacheco, Ella Richardson. Vice President, Blaine Stone Cipher, and President, Nikechi Moeta. Officers, thank you for your service to the Byron Nelson Choir Program. Students have many opportunities over the course of the year to be involved in extracurricular activities for choir. Taking advantage of this takes extra time and commitment from each student. And we would like to recognize them for their hard work and accomplishments. These students prepare a song for a judge to sing on their own and receive a superior rating from the judge at this year's virtual solo contest. Abby Horn, Abigail York, Alex Harton, Allison Ramos Santiago, Ava Famularo, Avery Marak, Blaine Stone Cipher, Brady Hansen, Brooklyn Taylor, Casey Miller, Dylan Hilbert, Elisa Mato, Ella Richardson, Emily Kinzig, Haley Vick, Hannah Hunt, Jackson Lacefield, Jillian Brown, Cadence Cunningham, Kai Diamond, Karis Rogers, Kathleen Forte, Katie Freeman, Koya Cunningham, Marissa Lacefield, Michael Gary, Molly Elder, Oliver Homan, Peyton Pulley, Samantha Leese, Samantha Linenkugel, and Violet Novak.
The Texas All-State Choir process is the largest singing contest in the country, possibly the world. Making the All-Region Choir is just the first step in the process. Each of these students competed against the best singers in our region and were selected as one of the top singers in their section to perform with the All-Region Choir. This year's Byron Nelson All-Region Choir members are, for the Treble Choir, Anna Tapia, Avery Marak, Brooklyn Taylor, Copeland Taylor, Ella Richardson, Haley Vick, Jasia Paris, Kathleen Forte, Peyton Pulley, Samantha Leese, Sydney McMillan, and Violet Novak. For the All-Region Mixed Choir, we have Abby Horn, Abigail York, Alex Harton, Ava Famularo, Lane Stone Cipher, Elisa Mato, Jackson Lacefield, Jillian Brown, Jordan Brooks, Judson Bauman, Kai Diamond, Marissa Lacefield, Michael Gehrig, and Oliver Homan. This year, we had three Byron Nelson students earn placement in the All-State Ensembles. These students are Kai Diamond, Oliver Homan, and Marissa Lacefield. Congratulations on achieving such a high honor. We are so proud of you.
Along with recognizing the important accomplishments and successes of our students, we also feel it's important to recognize the days of our lives in the choir room. Those events and students who endear themselves because of the quirky things they do or say. There are many, let me tell you, and we are only recognizing a few here today.
For cantate, we have Most Likely to Be on Broadway, Ligia Soto, Best Energy, Tess Sikierski, Best Drip, Grace Lane, Class Comedian, Brittany Flores Martinez, and your 2021 choir parents, Brie LaBelle and Serenity Norman Allen. For Bella Voce, we have Most Likely to Be a Famous Singer, Cadence Cunningham, Most Likely to Trip on Air, Delaney Beck, Most Likely to Be President, Jasia Paris, Most Likely to Be a Cat Lady, Corinne Demron, Most Likely to Be a TikTok Star, Samantha Lease, Best Hair, Mr. Sycon, Best Energy, Elizabeth Beasley, and Most Forgetful, Jasmine Manduhano Pacheco.
For Men's Choir, Most Energetic, me, Mr. Sycon. Best Dressed, Jackson Lacefield. Most Likely to Be on Your Cell Phone During Class, Dylan Andrews. Most Likely to Be Beaten Behind Walmart by Mr. Sycon, Braden Petty. For Voxomio, Most Likely to Be a Pop Star, Koya Cunningham. Most Likely to Be Roasted by Mr. Sycon, Judson Bauman. Most Likely to Miss Your Lesson, Dylan Hilbert. Most Likely to Be Tardy to Vokes, Marissa Lacefield. For a cappella, Most Likely to Trip on Air, Violet Novak. Most Likely to Be Roasted by Sycon, the a cappella tenors. Most Positive, Peyton Pulley. Most Gullible, Dylan Hilbert. Smarty Pants, Oliver Homan. Coffeeholic, Marissa Lacefield. Most Movement While Singing, Koya Cunningham. Best Dynamic Duo, Dylan Hilbert and Koya Cunningham. Most Likely to Be on Broadway, Alisa Mado. Future Choir Teacher, Jillian Brown. And Choir Fashionista, Ava Famularo.
Now on to the more serious awards. We present four types of awards this evening: Outstanding Achievement, Musicianship, Choir Spirit, and the Director's Award. This first award is Outstanding Achievement Award. We have a department of outstanding achievers. Tonight, we want to recognize those in our classes who have worked hard and accomplished much. Outstanding Achievement Awards go to Abby Horn, Abby York, Alex Harton, Blaine Stonecipher, Hannah Hunt, Jackson Lacefield, Jordan Brooks, Judson Bauman, Kai Diamond, Kathleen Forte, Marissa Lacefield, Michael Gehrig, Samantha Lease, and Tess Sikierski.
Many people mistakenly believe that a fine musician is someone who is simply gifted. The fact is that a great musician is someone who works at their craft. An outstanding musician is someone who leads, loudly or quietly, who is always present in body, mind, and spirit, who is a good musician and who loves the art of music making. Having a successful choir isn't dependent upon having a choir of great voices. It's dependent upon having a choir of great musicians. We're fortunate to have many. Receiving this year's musicianship awards are Alejandro Gomez, Allison Ramos Santiago, Amber Mitchell, Avery Marak, Belle File, Brianna Brokenberry, Brooklyn Taylor, Cal Smith, Casey Miller, Isha Ganam Venkata, Alisa Mado, Haley Vick, Hunter Stenger, Jasmine Manduhano Pacheco, Jossia Paris, Kayla Coleman, Koya Cunningham, Lauren Wettengel, Lily Harding, Luke Sechrist, Maddie Davis, Varsha Muthukrishnan, and Violet Novak.
Next, we present the Choir Spirit Award. A spirited person is excited, energetic, positive, enthusiastic, and committed. They don't have to be doing cartwheels across the choir room floor, but they exude the essence of what the love of music making is. Being up when everyone else is down, going the extra mile to make it work, committing themselves to the goal even when they are exhausted, and always giving it their all. I know that I draw energy every day from those that are choir spirited. Receiving this year's Choir Spirit Awards are Cash Carruthers, Corinne Demron, Delaney Beck, Dylan Hilbert, Elizabeth Beasley, Ella Richardson, Emily Weathers, Erica Wally, Ethan Hilbert, Gia Corio, Jordan Collins, Julia Miller Franklin, Karis Rogers, Leisha Soto, Molly Elder, Peyton Pulley, Raziel Mayora, Tyrone Tab, and Victoria Bianco.
When we have had the opportunity in the past, we have given this fourth award, the Director's Award. Recipients of the Director's Award could easily win each of the other three awards. These recipients of the Director's Award have achieved much in choir and other areas of the Fine Arts Department. These recipients work hard daily for choir, whether it be in front of the group running class or behind the scenes volunteering time to do the thankless jobs. Both recipients are beyond spirited when it comes to Byron Nelson Choir. The recipients of this year's Director's Award are Nikechi Moeta and Oliver Homan.
At this time, we would like to recognize our graduating seniors with this video presentation.
Oh, this APES homework is so hard. Okay, some people may think I'm rich, but I don't think I am. But if you need a ride, we can take my Tesla. I miss Java.
I will keep still.
What's the best choir song? The Sounding Sea.
See ya. Did one of you move my car seat?
No.
You guys want to go get coffee or like go to Sonic or something?
No.
No. No. Okay. Bye.
Hi guys, it is the Judson Bauman.
Mr. Saigon, what measure are we on?
All right, class is over. Okay, I'm gonna go get some water. I'll be right back. Oh man, I love drinking water. Blaine! That's a really good joke, Blaine. I'm gonna repeat it 30 more times as if the class did not hear me.
Hey, if you were looking in the music, that's your Discord. I know it's minute detail. You're actually wrong. I'm wrong, but I'm not going to say that.
All right, guys, it was fun seeing you this year. I really love you guys. I wish I could come back. I probably will, even though I'm an alumni. I'll see you later, though. Did Koya park behind me?
Senior, so currently I only have 13 of y'all senior gifts. I really need you guys to get those in, so please get those in soon, or I will literally hit you over the head with it. Just kidding, I won't. But, like, I will, like, get those in, like, right now. Girl, anyways. No. Whatever, I'm getting new ones. Where should I put it? No, like, I love Disney. Like, I don't... Like, I don't think you understand. Like, I really love Disney.
Are you ready, Tanners?
Oh, this lighting is super bad.
Hey, babe.
There ever was a perfect couple. This was qualified.
Hey, hottie, I love you.
Are you coming?
No, I'll fall.
Hey, darling, what's up? How you doing?
Hi, my name is Ethan McClain. I like God, my mama, and before all that, Kyle Children. Oh, this ain't baseball. Oh, class is over. Picking time. Ethan McClain, don't kill me.
Hi, I'm Oliver, and yeah, I can see your bald spots. Don't ask. So let it rain. It's rain. Rain on you. Nice. Good job, Kai.
Natural 20, let's go, boys!
Oh yeah, that calc test? Super easy. Didn't study, got like a 309, probably something higher. Don't worry about it, like, it's not a big deal.
Oh, what am I doing? Just reading and memorizing every single word in the new D&D book that came out about, 20 seconds ago. I'm already on page 132. Not bad.
Oh, wow. That's probably concussion number 17 now. Yikes. I guess the one good thing out of this is that I'm winning the concussion wars against my brother. Let's make it 18. Oh, yep, that's 18.
What's up? My name's Dylan. They call me Dilbert. I was nominated for all the awards and folks. Sheesh. I was nominated for clumsy, which I just don't get. Right, and that's what I was saying. I didn't want to say anything, but. I don't want to say anything, but you jilted me, say it, Jen. You brought it up. I got into it with you.
Hey, girl, do you want to come pee with me? Let's go to the bathroom.
Oh my gosh, you won't believe what happened to Sukkot today. It was crazy.
You need to come to this prom that I'm planning. There's going to be a food truck. You should come to Milestone tonight. I'm singing soprano too, and every new guest gets 2 pieces of pizza. Okay, bye, Illy.
Thanks for taking me home today.
Oh yeah, it's no problem. No biggie at all. Oh my gosh, you're gonna love this. Ready? It's my cute little rainbow fairy lights. Aren't they so cute?
Isn't that a little dangerous?
No, it'll be fine. Okay, let's get going.
All right, okay.
You're watching Bobcat, Bobcat, Bobcat. Oh, sorry. Hi, I'm Brandon. I've been in choir for a little while. I started out in men's choir, and then I moved my way up to a cappella. And before anyone says anything, I know this isn't a red hoodie. Red hoodie's in the wash. I'm really, really sorry. But, you know, I just wanted to say thank you to Mr. Sycon and Miss Engel, who isn't here anymore. But, you know, we miss you, Miss Engel. But also, it was great to have you, Miss Rawls. Anyway, it was really fun doing choir with all of you. Thank you.
Hey, guys. My name is Nathaniel Washbucket. I've been Washburn. I'm Vanessa's sister, if any of you guys were wondering. She graduated last year. So, I mean, obviously, I'm the better sibling.
Hey, what song is this? What song is this?
It's a different song.
So golden.
Hi, I'm Tori. I don't know how to drive. Well, at least not legally.
Tori, what are you doing?
I'm shopping on Shein.
Okay, so I just got this new shirt. What do we think? I really like it. It's really comfy and it's super soft. I think I'm gonna shave my head.
Oh my gosh, hi, my name's Koya. You wanna be friends? Did you donate to her drive? No? I don't think it's gonna work out.
Oh, you like my shirt? It's from Goodwill.
Guys, I think I should start being nicer to Judson. I don't know though. Sopranos. I am the honorary section leader, I think. And I'm just better than all of you. Guys, Brooklyn is skipping again today. Abby, look at this new crystal I got. I know it's supposed to hold candles, but like, multi-use, right? Okay, guys. I think we all know that I'm Mr. Sycon's favorite. Maybe you guys should try a little harder. Abby, I like the fit today. All right. Guys, Derek just texted me. Yeah.
Abby, what measure are we at?
Guys, I really think me and Derek are gonna get married. But he's allergic to my cat, so I don't think it's gonna work out.
Hey guys. Okay, I was having a little bit of car trouble. Two of my tires popped. My bumper fell off in the middle of the road. Get a new car. And who about to pay for that one? Not me, girl. Okay, but I did bring some gummy bears. Y'all want some? I got you. Oh. Boy, what?
Hi, I'm Karis, and this is my three rapid-fire impressions for my lovely seniors.
Hey, Jasmine, you look so cute today.
Oh, stop, thank you. Stop, thank you. Stop, thank you, stop, thank you. I'm Sarah Poole, and I don't talk a lot in class, but look, I would never admit this out loud, but it's because I'm carrying the entire choir. You all know it. You just don't want to admit it either.
Disclaimer. Sarah Poole is way too nice to ever say anything like this. Although, I'm afraid if we left her alone long enough, she could take over the universe. But she would thank you as she did it. Love you, Sarah.
Oliver, come look at the stats I just rolled for my new character in D&D.
Y'all are the champions, seniors.
Hey guys, so if you don't know me, my name is Jillian Brown. I've been a part of choir for 4 years. And little did I know that it was going to be the best blessing in disguise in my life. So 4 years ago, I was a completely different person. And I think you hear that every year, but it really was the truth. And if it weren't for choir, I don't know who I would be or what I would be doing. And so y'all are such a big part of that. And I want to thank everyone for that. And, you know, there's really something special that happens at pack of 114. So it's been such a ride and such an incredible joy to be a part of this. And, you know, I cannot thank y'all enough for the 6-period lunches, the library organizing, for just about everything. And Mr. Saikon, I want to thank you for pushing every single one of us to do our best every day. And, you know, there was never a day that I didn't want to come to choir. And Ms. Rawls, I want to thank you for always being there to answer my questions, whether it be about life, college, music, whatever. You're always there, and I cannot thank you enough. I also want to say, in the middle of a pandemic, we were able to make the most amazing music, and it was such a blessing. And there's so much gratitude I have. Like, I can't put it into words, but it's been an incredible year. It's been an incredible ride. Go Pokes! And I'm running out of time. Bye!
I'd like to thank Mr. Saikon for giving me amazing opportunities these past 4 years, like performing the Mozart Requiem, which I don't think I'll ever forget. I'd also like to thank Ms. Rawls for all the fun lunch games and memories I've had this year. And thank you to the alto section. It's been amazing being section leader this year. And thank you to choir in general for giving me a space to show all of my creative outlooks. I don't know what I'd be doing without choir as a part of my life. So thank you very much.
I just want to preface this by saying, I don't know what to say. I've been in choir for ever since the 6th grade. And to be frank, I thought it was the easiest. I thought it was the cheapest. And I wasn't wrong in some cases. It definitely was the cheapest than like buying an instrument. But it was definitely not the easiest. And I learned very quickly, I fell in love with choir. And ever since first day of freshman year, I was mortified. I was terrified. But then I saw Mr. Saikon and I heard his stupid jokes, and they always managed to light my day up. I could not have asked for a better experience, because these are memories I will take all the way until the end of my life. And Ms. Rawls, you have done so much. What you have done this year is so commendable. And you have earned my respect. It takes a lot to do what you have done this year. And for that, I'm just gonna have to say thank you. Thank you so much for what has become my favorite part of high school.
Hi everyone. I'm thinking back to the moment when I first walked through the doors of the choir hall. As a little tiny freshman, I didn't know anyone, and I was late to class because I didn't realize how far the choir hall was from the rest of the school. And I didn't know it then, but what I was actually walking into wasn't just choir class, it was a family. And my family still to this day has and always will be BNHS choir. I am just so incredibly thankful for the time that I've been able to spend here the past 4 years. It has stretched me. It has grown me so much, not just musically, but also as a person. And I have been able to meet some of the best people in this program. Just amazing friends and people who have helped me grow, and just amazing people. And some of those amazing people would be our directors, Mr. Saikon and Ms. Rawls. I just wanted to say thank you so much for all that you do for all of us and all that you have both done for me. I'm really grateful for the time that we've spent together, and I know that y'all don't get enough thanks for what you do, but you deserve it because y'all are some of the best teachers that we have here at Byron, I'm convinced. And I just am really gonna miss being here next year. I'm gonna miss being in this choir at the school, because there really is something that's very special about Byron Nelson Choir. So I just wanted to say thank you to everyone who has been a part of my life throughout these past 4 years. And I'm really gonna miss you all. And Byron Nelson Choir will always hold a very, very special place in my heart. So I love you, BNHS Choir.
Hi, it's Jasmine.
And it's Ava.
And we just wanted to start off by saying thank you to this department for giving us all the opportunities that we have to be able to express ourselves through beautiful music as a group, and
just having a family outside of our homes at school.
Yes, and to Mr. Cyclone, thank you for being the best director we could have asked for. You have just been such an amazing teacher, and you have blessed us with so many opportunities, and you have opened so many doors for us to continue in college, and we couldn't have asked for a better teacher to lead us throughout these 4 years.
And for giving us all the jokes that we would always hear, because I remember all of them still, even from like freshman year. I want to say thank you to Ms. Rawls, because you made my last year of high school so memorable, so fun. All the girls in Bella absolutely love you, and we're going to miss you so much.
Yes, we wish you the best wherever you go. We know you're going to bless so many kids, and so yeah, we're going to miss you guys.
Thank you, Byron Nelson Choir.
We love you.
Hello everybody, Dylan here. What can I say except wow, what an amazing 4 years that I've had. A lot of you I might not be friends with today if it hadn't been for me continuing in choir, and I owe all of it to Mr. Cyclone, to be honest. I have this funny story which I've told to some of you, but I'm gonna go ahead and say it again. When I was a freshman applying for choir in high school, I signed up for choir with the expectation that it was going to be just like middle school, and boy was I wrong. When I saw my schedule, I saw a cappella choir and was like, okay, kind of just brushed it to the side, didn't really think anything of it. But when I got to class and I was in a classroom full of juniors and seniors, I nearly had a stroke. And after one day of singing together, I got pretty intimidated, and I went and asked Cyclone if I could drop choir. And I don't know what I was thinking at the time, but thank goodness for his response. He said something on the lines of, look, you're here now, you're meant to be here. I could take you out, but I don't think that's the right choice. And in the end, I am so glad he told me that, because I stayed and had an amazing 4 year experience getting to sing countless amazing pieces with all of you, and I couldn't be more grateful. And thanks to him, I'm deciding to be a music educator in college and go on and hope to be another Cyclone. I only wish my dad jokes are half as special as his, and I will miss you all. Thank you so much for the wonderful opportunities that I've had in this program, and for all of the amazing friendships that have just been forged along the way. I love you all.
Hey guys, I just wanted to thank Ms. Rawls and Mr. Cyclone for an amazing year this year. Even with the pandemic, it has been just such a fun year. We have accomplished so much music and made so many memories. So thank you guys for that. And also thank you so much for an amazing 4 years in choir. I wouldn't have rather done anything else each year at Byron Nelson than be in choir. And I looked forward to it every day. And it always just made my day. I've had so much fun, made so much music. We sang so much. It was just amazing. So thank you so much for that. And all the memories we made of UIL and getting sweepstakes, and especially this previous pop concert, doing solos and just having fun with everyone and all the friends I made. It has been just such an amazing experience. And I really appreciate that everything y'all have done for me. So thank you so much.
Hey, everyone. In short, the past 4 years have been nothing but amazing. I cannot imagine my life without a choir and without all of you. It has been the only thing that has kept me going these past years, especially this year with everything going on. And believe it or not, eighth grade, I was still gonna be an athlete. I was still playing soccer, and that was my world, right? And that kind of changed when got another concussion, because you know me. And I've never been so glad to have gotten kicked in the head, because you know, that put me here, and this is exactly where I want to be. I could not imagine having missed all the beautiful music we've made and all the great friendships I've made, because those memories, it's the best I've got. Like, that means the world to me. So just thank you guys for the past 4 years. It is the best anyone could have ever hoped or dreamed for. I love all of you guys, and I wish you the best.
It's been real, yo. Peace out.
Hey y'all, and Catchy here, and I would just like to say a big thank you to everyone at the BNHS choir department, because over the last years in that choir room, I have matured, I have grown, I have learned, and now I can say that I am graduating as a better person than I was when I came into the choir room for the first time as a freshman. I would like to thank Mr. Sycon so much for his love, his perseverance, and for always seeing the end before we even get there. There's something about Sycon saying, "I know you're tired, but I don't care," that actually motivates you a little bit. I would like to say a big thank you to Ms. Rawls. Thank you so much for joining our very dysfunctional family in the middle of a pandemic. Like, your courage and your bravery is so inspiring, and I can only hope to be as half as brave as you are one day. I would like to give a big shout out to my amazing officer board and my amazing Vice President Blaine. You guys have made a crazy year as less crazy as it could be. Thank you guys so much for dealing with me and pushing to make sure this year is great. And to everyone at the BNHS Choir Department, again, thank you so much. I hope that I will see the department flourish and thrive, and just know that there's a crazy girl somewhere in the world that is rooting you on. Love you guys so, so, so much.
Thank you, seniors. We love you guys. Now, we have a special video dedication to our seniors.
Seniors, we love you and we wish you the best. Now, please enjoy the slideshow presentation from our historians.
I'm on cell 36.
Hey, did you see my new lock screen?
Oh, I'm gonna go finesse that. Watch me.
Why?
They do. They make so much money. I'm on super truck.
We would like to give a special thank you to Sam Leese and Abby Horn for their work on collecting pictures and putting together videos.
Hi everyone! This year has been quite extraordinary, to say the least. Thinking back to the beginning of the year when we were all quarantined at home, experiencing virtual learning for the very first time, I had no idea what this year was going to look like. Who knew that we would go from virtual learning to a full capacity in-person concert to close out the year? It's been crazy and it's been weird, and I hope that next year is a little bit closer to normal. However, I wanted to reflect upon my favorite memories with the BNHS choir, many of which are my first memories as a choir director. Our winter concert. I remember Mr. Sycon and I scrambling to figure out how an in-person concert in the middle of a pandemic would work. It was crazy, and it was the first concert I've ever seen without risers and requiring tickets to enter. Aside from all the crazy, this concert will always be really special to me, as it was my first concert as a choir director. Godspell! This was my first musical to be a director of, and I'm so grateful to have shared this experience with the BNHS Fine Arts Department. Even though it was cut short, the two performances the cast put on were the absolute best high school performances I have ever seen. Those of you that are in the cast are superhuman for saving it in one day when other cast members had to quarantine. The Godspell cast and crew is so deserving of all of the awards they've been nominated for this year. Outstanding. Now UIL, it's always a big feat, but especially this year. to be able to sing with masks on, socially distanced, and sound like a well-blended choir is something I didn't think was possible at all. And you did it, and you handled it with grace. I'm so proud of the work each ensemble put into our UAL contest videos this year. We truly defied the odds and put on wonderful performances despite the obstacles we faced. It's also pretty cool to get to brag to my friends about how well you guys did at concert. Once again, congratulations. Now, my most favorite memory from this year was definitely our pop concert. This was the most exciting and seemingly normal thing we've experienced all year. And it was just so much fun to get to sit in the audience and admire your talent. When I grow up, I want to be performers like you. Seniors, I want to take a moment to thank you for all you have given to the Byron Nelson Choir Department. It has been such an honor to get to know you this past year. If you need any big sister advice about college, I am always a text away. Please keep in touch with me and contact me if you need anything at all. Thank you so much, seniors, for all you've done. We love you. Mr. Saigon, I know this year has been difficult, but I think we did pretty well considering the obstacles we faced. Thank you for being a wonderful mentor to me during my very first year of teaching. It's been incredible to get to work with you and the BNHS Choir Department. I'm so sad to be leaving, but I know they're in good hands. Thank you. To all of our choir students, my time with you has been cut short, but it was the most wonderful experience to have. Thank you for helping me through this year. It's been outrageously hard, and you all were the ones that kept me going. It's been such a joy to get to create music with you. You all are so incredible, hardworking, kind, and talented. I love you all so much, and it breaks my heart to have to leave you so soon. Never stop singing, and always go the distance. Please keep in touch with me. Let me know when your concerts or musicals are, and I will be there. I will always be your biggest fan. I love you all.
Here we are, Bobcats. The 12th year in Byron Nelson Choir history is coming to a close, and what a crazy year it has been. For me, this year came in three phases: panic, then sadness, and finally joy. My panic phase started way back on the first day of school, which now seems like a lifetime ago, when I was teaching choir to a computer screen from the guest bedroom of my house, where I happen to be right now. I couldn't hear anyone singing, and I wasn't sure if anyone was listening to what I was saying. During this panic phase, I had several of my non-teacher friends ask, "So how's that pandemic thing working out for choir?" And my response was always, "It's just like normal, only you can't hear anyone sing and you can't tell if anyone cares what you have to say." It was my sarcastic way of saying, everything is different and I don't know what I'm doing. For the first time in 17 years, I felt absolutely lost in my profession and I was in a frenzy trying anything to keep something being learned about choir. Once we returned back to school, sadness set in. Most of us were back in person, and I think I know how to teach choir in person. However, with masks on our faces and 6 feet or more of social distancing between each student, things were slow at best. I felt like I didn't even know you all because it had been months since we had seen each other. And from the front of the classroom, with my glasses fogging, I didn't even recognize the half-covered faces looking back at me. I drove to work in silence most days because any choir song that popped up on my radio, yes, I know, I'm that nerdy, any choir song that popped up on my radio would get me thinking about how great our choirs could be if things were just normal. And I cried myself to work more than I care to admit. However, when I talk about this year and years to come, it's not going to be a sad story. Right around our holiday concert, we turned a corner and finally the joy arrived. I realized that our choirs were all singing fantastic music. Instead of thinking Here are the things we can't do because COVID. I started to see all of the amazing things we were doing despite COVID. For example, we shared 3 amazing concerts with the public, including our packed pop concert, where I sat backstage fighting back tears because I was so proud of our choirs and soloists who were cheering each other on like rock stars. When you have the chance, rewatch the beginning of this video and look at our lists of All Region, All State, UIL, and solo contest successes. No one would have any idea that the pandemic limited us. That's because of what I was reminded of this year. Nothing, not even a pandemic, can stop the amazing Byron Nelson Choir Department. Speaking of UIL successes, Men's Choir, we competed for the very first time as a standalone choir at UIL, and we were just 1 point shy of sweepstakes. You guys are the hardest working choir that I know. Thank you. Miss Rawls, I got to watch you lead Cantate and Bella Voce to a sweepstakes victory in your UIL debut. I am so proud of you and of the treble choirs. Thank you for your hard work this year. I don't know any teacher that cares more about their students than you do. A cappella, your UIL performance of Dire Ton took my breath away. I have no words to describe the feeling of standing in front of you and Mrs. Rogers during our UIL recording day. Your artistry and musicianship continue to be a gift to me, and I am so grateful for each one of you. Seniors, this is a bittersweet time when we have to say farewell. I am simultaneously so proud of your accomplishments in your 4 years at Byron Nelson, and so sad that our time together is coming to an end. I hope that when you look back on our time together, that your mind, like mine, can make the shift from pondering the things we couldn't do to focusing on the extraordinary things that we did, despite COVID-19. Please stay in touch so that I can see all of the amazing places life will take you. Choir, whether you are ending your first year in Byron Nelson or ending your 4th year in our choir family, I want you to know that I'm so proud to be your director. I cannot wait to be a part of the great things that are in store for the Byron Nelson Choir Department in the future. So, Bobcats, that's all for now. Until next time, remember, never miss an opportunity to make beautiful music.
Don't you worry about a stand.